Let's talk about the Central Sanskrit University's Bill 2019. Now, this is an interesting bill. As in the Ayurveda bill, we have seen that the three institutes have been merged into one. Here, the three institutes have been converted into the Central Sanskrit Universities, and those are the Rashtriya Sanskrit Sansthan, New Delhi. Then you had the Rashtriya Sanskrit Vidyapeet in the name of Lal Bahadur Shastri. Then that is again in New Delhi. And then you have one in Tirupati, which is the Rashtriya Sanskrit Vidyapeet. So both of them are Rashtriya Sanskrit Vidyapeet. One of them has Lal Bahadur Shastri as a prefix, so that is in Delhi, and the other one is in Tirupati. Now all these three would be converted to Central Sanskrit Universities. So that is the sole idea of this bill. Now again, these institutions which have been converted into the Vidyapeeths and the deemed to be universities that have been converted into the Central Sanskrit University would be having an idea to improve Sanskrit knowledge, to promote Sanskrit learning, to bring in eminent Sanskrit scholars, and also integrate various courses of humanities, social sciences along with Sanskrit as one of the languages. The idea is to train manpower for overall development and global approach. So what are the key highlights? The idea would be again to conduct training programs, grant degree, diploma and certificate courses, provide them more autonomy. And as we have seen in the previous bills on Ayurveda University, Triple IIT bill, we have seen the idea of promotion of self-autonomy or self-funding is one of the key ideas that we have seen. Promoting education in Sanskrit, and then there would be a tribunal of arbitration. Now, what does this mean? If there is any dispute that comes or is taken by the university against a student, then they can refer to the tribunal of arbitration. Now these disputes can be between an employee or a university, a student and a university, and this tribunal would have three persons would be part of it. One member would be from the executive council. One of the members would be nominated by the employee or the students concerned, and there would be one who would be appointed by the visitor. Now who is the visitor? President of India is the visitor to this university. Okay, so you would have one member that would be nominated by the visitor. Now what is the composition of the university? You would have a court. Now this is not a legal court, but the idea of this court is to review the policy making of the Central Sanskrit Universities. There would be an executive council which would look after the administration and policies, academic and activity council, board of studies, finance committee and planning and monitoring board. Now the council would have 15 members, of which two would be eminent scholars from the field of Sanskrit itself. As we said, president would be the visitor to the university, and in the tribunal of arbitration, he would have the ability to nominate one of the persons as a mediator. And if any of the student feels that their roll number is being removed from the university or they are being barred from appearing into examination, they can bring their appeal directly to the executive council, and the decision can be reviewed with transparency. So that is the sole idea of this whole functionality and the divisions of the various councils and committees. We would be covering many more interesting bills in the upcoming sessions. So stay tuned. Have a wonderful day.